Hello, Assalamu alaikum, and welcome back to the final part of our show. Today we're discussing right to buy. You're joining myself, Haseena Momtaz, and Cam Ali. But as I said previously, we will answer questions on any aspect of property development and management. And just before we went to the break, we had a great question. I think Cam Bai can answer that.
The question was, he's a first-time self-employed person. What would he need to get a mortgage? Now, it's obviously you need your ID, you need to be a British citizen or have indefinite leave to remain in the UK. There's his SA302s, which summarizes self-employed person's income and some proof of address. And that's it really, and some asset and liabilities, whether he has any loans and credit cards. So it's not that difficult. If he has any difficulties, just get hold of a mortgage broker and they'll take him through the process. Or just approach the high street banks, make an appointment, and they'll give him a list of few things that he needs. Okay. That's it really, so it's not very difficult to get a first time.
The broker can take care of that. Normally, do brokers, do they charge a fee to the client or is it to the provider,
it's
the person giving the mortgage?
It's best to ask the broker. Some brokers do charge, some brokers do it for free because they all brokers get commission from the bank, you see.
Yeah.
So, if you approach a high street bank, there's no broker fees because you're approaching one of the bank's employees who's a qualified broker doing it. So, yeah.
Okay, well great. We will come back to the question about the EU referendum, but in the meantime we've got another caller.
Right, yeah.
So, hello, assalamu alaikum and welcome to the studio. Oh, unfortunately that caller's gone. So we were talking about things might be a little bit tricky just straight after the EU referendum, but you were going to advise people to hang on.
Yeah, I mean the market is reasonably flat at the moment because of uncertainty in the market, and so you have to change strategy. You can't say, look, I'm going to buy something now and sell it in 6 months for a huge profit. And with property, it's always long term, and you have to ride the cycle, if you like. So eventually you make your money. There might be dips along the way, but if you're able to hold on to it long term, the problem is where people panic and they're not able to hold on to the properties and they sell it for cheap, so that's where they lose the money. Otherwise, if you're able to hold on, you'll always make the money. And we all know, you know, every 10 years property doubles in value in the UK. So if there are dips because of certain referendums or uncertainties or interest rates, you do have to try and hold on to the properties. And that's how you do it. Ride the cycle, as we say. And change your strategy. I mean, if you're a full-time investor, you know, if you're doing small developments, you can buy to hold and enjoy the rents, improve your properties, get a better yield. So, you have to change as the market condition changes, economic situation, you have to also change, adapt to new strategies.
So have that kind of long-term mindset.
Property is always long-term. You cannot, you can get your fingers burned if you're thinking short-term on property, yes.
Okay. Now, you mentioned that the market is flat at the moment. Are you talking about prices, and would that mean it's a good time to buy?
This is it. I mean, the government is trying its hardest, making efforts to cool the market down so first-time buyers have an opportunity. Because I don't believe anybody wants a crash in the market where, and then there's a bigger problem. So we don't know. I mean, it's last few weeks it's been rather quiet in the sense that it's not going up any huge. And there's already problem at the high end of the market where £3-5 million because of the stamp duty changes, so prices are having an impact. But on the day-to-day stuff, it's absolutely fine. I mean, it's not dropping in value and rents are good. You have to see what your yields are, but certainly in London, some of the properties, the yields are not great anymore, where you can't get 6-7%, 8%, it's 3%. So people are taking the view, is it worth me getting it? Because the interest rate possibly could go up in a few years. So is a good opportunity for first-time buyers to see if there is something on the market they like and they buy to live in. It could make sense for them.
Okay. I mean, we've got about 10 minutes left on air, so please do call through with your questions, any questions relating to property, mortgages, investments.
There's one more thing as changes. Last week, one of the biggest lenders nationwide, actually, on the buy-to-let mortgages, the rent cover from 125% to 145%. So if there's a property or an area where the rent is not very high, you could be put in a deposit instead of 20-25%, possibly 30-35%, because the rent cover isn't. This is down to the tax changes. So, and the other lenders are following as well.
Okay.
So there are further squeezes on the buy-to-let investor. So if somebody is applying for a buy-to-let mortgage for a property, they might get angry on you. You have to put in another 20, 30, 40, £6,000, whereas last year or a couple of months ago, you wouldn't have to do that. So there's a further disadvantage, if you like, because investors don't want to put in, they want to spread it to the next property, and that's why it's giving first-time buyers an opportunity as well, because certain investors will pull out because of the
huge... Let me just ask you to pause there for a moment, because we've got another caller. Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Welcome to our show, to your property show. What's your question?
আমি একটা প্রশ্ন করতে জিজ্ঞাসা জানতাম সে না তার কাছ থেকে আমার এক ফ্রেন্ড আপনার তাই অসুস্থ মানুষ ডিসেবিলিটি বেনিফিট পাইন কাউন্সিল করো তখন তো তাই রাইট টু বাই স্কিমে তার গোটা লইতেছে এই আরকি ফ্ল্যাটটা তার বাইয়েন্তে গিফট দিবা তান যে মানে দুই বাইয়ে তো এটা লোয়ার রাইট আছে না তাই
এটা তানজনে কোনো মর্গেজ আনা লাগে না এখানে আই ডোন্ট বিলিভ কোনো লেন্ডারে তার মর্গেজ দিবে কিনলা দেন ওদিন আপনি প্রুফ দিতে পারেন তারারে বলে যে কিতা আমি গিফট পাইছি আমার বাইর গেছে থাকি ব্যাংক স্টেটমেন্ট লেটার দ্যাট উইল সাফাইস সো যে কিতা
এটা মানে ডাক্তার তো আমাদের আনফিট করে লেছে ওয়াক্তে গত দিন কাম করছেন আপনার বাইরে
এটা ঠিক আছে তারা রাইট আছে কাউন্সিলে আগেই তো জিগাই তো না অঙ্ক কিছু জিগাই তো পারে বলে লোক সাডেনলি তুমি হাউজিং বেনিফিট আসলে অতদিন আর এটা ফাইলা যদি কই নাকি গিফট পাইছো এটা তার রাইট আছে এটা কেন হেউ স্টপ করতো না এখান দিয়ে হি অ্যাবসলিউট গো হেড এন্ড বাই ইট ইজ নট নো প্রবলেম
ওকে থ্যাংক ইউ ওকে
ওকে গ্রেট কোয়েশ্চন আই থিংক উই আর গোনা গো স্ট্রেট অন টু অ্যানাদার কলার ওকে দ্যাট কলার ইজ গন সো ইউ ওয়্যার টকিং অ্যাবাউট
ইজ দেয়ার এনি ভ্যালু ইন বাই টু লেটস নাও আই মিন ইটস আপ টু দ্য ইন্ডিভিজুয়ালস বাট সার্টেনলি হোয়াট আই এম সিইং নাও ওয়্যার পিপল হ্যাভ not had the opportunity to buy, now they're saying, look, I'm going to buy, it's not that competitive as 6 months ago, and they're possibly grabbing good opportunities, and they want to be on the property, they have the money. I say, look, I'd like to enjoy the rents rather than think, is it going to go up in the next few months? Am I going to sell for a massive profit within 6 months? So, you know, you do have to change your strategies.
Can I ask you to pause again? So yeah, sure. I think our caller's back. Hello?
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam. Thank you for calling. What's your question?
Ami property short matta aslam.
Je, kono problem nai. Oshubidha nai, apnar matukka. Apnar question? Hello?
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Ami studio matram ni.
Je, je, je.
Could you turn your TV off? I think you can't hear us because your TV's on in the background.
TV is off.
Okay. We can hear you now. What's your question?
আচ্ছা আমি ইদেশ হয়েছি 3 বছর হয়েছে তো আমি সেরকম একটা ঘর কিনতাম আমি এখন মর্গেজ পাইব নি
3 বছর হয়েছে আপনার যদি পাসপোর্টটা হয় ইনডেফিনিট লিভ থাকে পাসপোর্টও দেন ইট শুডন্ট বি আ প্রবলেম ও ব্রিটিশ যদি তা হয় না আপনি দেন ইজ নট আ প্রবলেম আর
ডিপেন্ড করে আরো 3 বছর লাগবে
জি ও দেন ইট মাই বি ডিফিকাল্ট বাট একজন ব্রোকার লাগে বুঝতে হইবা যে কোনো ল্যান্ডার আসেনি এটা আপনার মর্গেজ দিব আর প্লাস আপনার অবভিয়াসলি ডিপোজিট লাগবো প্লাস আপনার ইনকাম দেখাইতে হইব ইয়ে সাফিসিয়েন্ট টু বি এবল টু বাই দ্য প্রপার্টি গেট এ মর্গেজ তো আপনার যে কোন ধরনের ভিসা আপনার আছে তে রেজিডেন্স স্পাউস ভিসা 3 বছর হয়ে গেলে তো আপনার ইনডেফিনিট দিলাই না এটা না So I don't know what, if you've got a residence status, then you can, or indefinite leave, you can do it. Better if you have a broker, you can check it. There is a chance that it is now because you don't, if you have a mortgage there for 20 years or 40 years, you can get 3 years, but you have an indefinite leave fine, or then a bank will have to do it. But I know that if you have a bridging finance, as a lender, there. You can get bridging finance, but it's not a mortgage. It's a short term, like it's so much like a bus or like it there, very expensive. But mortgage there, Tara Bank of Lefna, Tin Bus or like in minimum 20 years, 15 years, but for Jibucho like that. That's why Tara Sai, the other Manush, it is a Tahar, right as a Tar, legality as a That's right. So, but you could still check. Highly unlikely apna dibo with that kind of visa. But I still suggest ekhon jodi broker log apne check korte eta. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you for your call. So we've got about 5 minutes left on air. We do have another question. Hello.
Hello.
Assalamu alaikum. Thank you for calling.
Hello,
what's your question?
One of the men. Acha ami ami bayesh ko chakto korbo.
Josh, bidan apna question to kabka.
Hoga. It's very easy. They make an application. Afnar rent khoto faida na hore survey korbo bade you have a new contract regulated unregulated buy to let is unregulated so afnar kono problem nai apply korte parba juni afnar kono default thake na ar kono major financial difficulties thake na then you can apply for it and debo tara depend kore kun lender loge apni depend kore kun lender loge bortomane asoin e lender juni buy to let kore na then you have to go to another lender that does buy to let and as long as there's enough equity in the property 25% rent tara mono hore rent cover thik ache then it's quite easy to switch it's not very difficult at all I would suggest again he approaches someone who has contacts with the non jokita with buy to let lenders so that's what it is yeah
okay great we have just a few more minutes left on air so if anybody has a quick question a very burning question please come through to us In the meantime, do you have any sort of closing comments?
Commodities call on right to buy today. Yeah, I mean, it's one of the most excellent financial moves you can ever make if somebody has the fortunate enough to have that opportunity. Like they're a secure tenant for 3 years and they shouldn't miss this opportunity. And as I was saying right at the beginning, I personally know a few good friends who have become very successful millionaires through the right to buys and they've done well I mean even if you don't become at least you'll be a homeowner and from there you can move up the property ladder
you can use that as leverage
for future properties and you know it's a good but on the other hand you do need to check that you can afford to pay the mortgage if somebody's been on housing benefit and never paid the rent and so you got to you'd have a mortgage and a service charge to pay
but so presumably the lender will look into those things
this is it whether you can afford but it's common you have to do some basic common sense check say look how much will my mortgage be can I maintain this for the foreseeable future and if you know when people come to me I say look if you've got a child who's maybe starting work in a year or so you got some backup there or I don't always advise people to sell their wife gold last week we spoke earlier that was a one off and the gentleman was very grateful because his only shortfall was a small amount and he can see that it was a fantastic opportunity £103,000 discount and a nice 3-bedroom house so Yeah, you have to look at your individual circumstances, whether you can afford it or not.
I think we are actually have come to the end of the show. So it just remains for me just to remind our viewers that we're not on next month because of Ramadan, but we will be back after Ramadan. I just want to thank all our callers who came in through to the studio today. Thank you for your questions. And thank you for watching. Thank you for joining us today. And inshallah, we'll see you next time. Please remember us in your du'as in Ramadan. Thank you and assalamu alaikum.